The gentleman yields back, and now we recognize the gentleman from Minnesota, Mr. Phillips, for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Greetings, Mr. Madrid and colleagues. In my past life as an entrepreneur, I engaged with a SCORE mentor who shared memorable and really impactful counsel with me that I've employed ever since in my business career. So I really know firsthand how impactful these programs can be, particularly for those who lack the experience or the mentorship networks, and particularly the access to capital that one needs to succeed as an entrepreneur. And I also believe deeply that business can and should be a means to an end. The end not being how much an owner can accrue in success, rather how much that owner can share with those who made it possible. And I really believe strongly that building this kind of stakeholder capitalism into business models is best done at early stages. So earlier in another hearing, Mr. Rowe mentioned succession planning and transitioning businesses to employee-owned models as an example of how SBDCs can engage in this work. So could you explain how OEP can maybe play a role in helping inspire more employee ownership at early stages of companies as they're seeking counsel to establish themselves?
Thank you, Congressman, on a very important topic in terms of, let's talk about ESOPs, for instance. We're delighted that the SBDC network in pockets of the country has introduced webinars that approach this topic. In fact, there was an ultimate linkage that occurred at OED, and connecting the dots is very, very important to us. And I'll talk about SCORE here in a moment. But literally, I was talking to an 8A certified firm that's a Native American business. And I was talking to the two sisters that opened this company, Sister Sky, that's been in operation for 20 years. And they had their, one of the sisters had her two daughters there. And she said, these two daughters are going to take over this family business. I was able to then, connect that with the ESOP training happening with the SBDC. So that's critical. As well, you mentioned mentorship. I have very diligent experience in the last experience where I led a nonprofit focusing on the largest cluster of scale Latinx firms in US history. Is mentorship was the secret sauce. So what SCORE has offered during the pandemic and their persistence through an online resilience hub has been beneficial. And as well, the WBCs are also having trainings throughout on succession planning. So I think we have our bases covered on a very important topic.
I appreciate that. And a note to my colleagues, I think Democrats and Republicans can agree that capitalism works best when we have more ownership, not less. And if we can bake some of these principles into early stage businesses with incentives and counsel and mentorship, I think we're all better off for it. My second question, Mr. Madrid, is relative to the CARES Act. Of course, it provided $25 million for SBDC and WBC associations to create a centralized platform, if you will, for COVID-19 resources and back-end and training platforms for counselors. You know, with funding for those programs set to expire in April, forthcoming in 2022, how would you categorize the success of that platform, and what were the metrics for success? And how would OED like to see the platform pivot perhaps to a post-pandemic use?
Thank you for that question, Congressman. The Resource Partner Training Portal is definitely a coalition building endeavor. So we thank America's SBDC and the Association of Women's Business Center for stewarding that particular platform. And the best way to talk about the platform and its success and the potential for the future is that most recently when we rolled out IDLE enhancements that through the Office of Capital Access, we partnered with the Resource Partner Training Portal. And that there was an appetite, frankly, for that from the business advisors across the resource partners, including SCORE and the VBOX, the Veteran Business Outreach Centers. We had a record attendance that was navigated through America's SBDC and the Association of Women's Business Centers. And so those are the type of metrics that we want to capture. They've captured, of course, attendance. And so we just need to keep pushing the metrics further. And I was encouraged by the couple of events that we've held together and more on the way if it continues.
I appreciate it, sir. With that, I yield back, Madam Chair. Thank you.